The Contributions to the Graduate Program Award recognizes graduate faculty who have a sustained record of teaching, mentoring, and advising graduate students. These faculty awardees have demonstrated a remarkable generosity and commitment to fostering the intellectual, creative, scholarly, and professional growth of our students who are pursuing the university's highest academic degrees, and nurture a community of intellectual engagement in which they thrive. It is my pleasure to announce the 2021 recipient of the Contribution to the Graduate Program Award, Dr. Jim Alicata from the Engineering Technology Department. Welcome, Jim, and congratulations.
Thank you very much.
So why don't we start a little bit about, if you could tell us a little bit about where you grew up and where you went to school.
Well, I started out and had an unusual background. I came from the town of Burlington, Massachusetts, and I was a person who loved farms and I loved cows and livestock, and which in Burlington at the time I was growing up, there weren't a lot of livestock there. Historically, they may have been, but there wasn't when I was in high school. And so I worked on other farms out in Concord and other places where there were dairy farms. And it brought me to go to the Stockbridge School of Agriculture at the University of Massachusetts in Amherst. I received an associate degree there in animal science and then transferred to the University of Arizona in Tucson, where I received my bachelor's degree in animal science and agricultural education. And then afterwards I taught high school vocational agriculture for a couple years, which was a great preparation for adjusting to the position I had here at the university, working in technology engineering and vocational education, because I understood hands-on learning. I had a familiarity with a different type of approach, vocational education as an approach.
And you jumped there, but how did you end up here at Fitchburg State?
Well, that was an interesting thing. I got the bug. Years ago, when I was working on my master's degree at Clark University, a colleague of mine from Amherst teased me and said, be careful you don't get the teaching bug. At the time, I was writing educational programs for farmers for the Massachusetts Department of Agriculture. Yeah. And with my master's degree, Clark asked me to teach some public administration classes on a part-time basis, and I did. And the interest became, I really enjoyed teaching again. And as my friend was fearful, I got the teaching bug, which there became a position here at Fitchburg State for a coordinator. They called it the Tech Prep Coordinator, which was a program that transitioned students from high school to college, made it easier for them to succeed going to college.
Can you tell us a bit about your approach to teaching graduate students?
The vocational community, historically, are students who are not familiar with going to college. They chose vocational careers because somebody, unfortunately, in their life may have told them they weren't college material. They wouldn't be successful in college. So many of these students come with the hardship or the baggage, if you will, of fear and lack of self-confidence in exploring an educational program and degree. What I've been doing is I encourage students, and I've been very successful, encouraging students to take it piecemeal, starting with their licensure program by taking the 39 credits that's required for professional licensure. And then I remind them those 39 credits are transferable towards a bachelor's degree. And I bring up the fact that they've already been giving up one night a week from their family, so why not continue? The family's used to this routine for a little bit longer.
Well, it seems to me, you know, after hearing all of that, that you've really were a forerunner, a visionary on things like shifting people's perception that they were, you know, they came with deficits, to really showing them they came with assets.
Absolutely.
And really you're a leader in adult education.
Today, with the technology we enjoy, it's so much easier, it's so much more effective that I'm seeing even in the vocational community that the vocational teachers, because of their background and their hands-on experience, were reluctant to adopt or go into and try any type of distance learning. It was always, they wanted to see face-to-face instruction, always. But now, the current generation coming through are younger and I think more familiar with technology, and now we're seeing a shift that they're actually preferring the online offered courses instead of the face-to-face. So I mean, it's a shift we've seen, and I've got a chance to witness it.
All these years of forging partnerships and seeing the development of graduate education, where would you like to see graduate education move towards into the future?
I would like to see us go national in the sense that we would offer people maybe from Nebraska or possibly Kansas, where they don't have a program, they could access our program and meet the requirements. When I started, And I say this proudly, I can remember very clearly visiting different schools, all of the administrators in these schools had academic backgrounds. Mm. Because it was typical that the academic teachers had bachelor's and master's degrees, which qualified them for the administrative positions in that vocational school district. What we've done with our master's program and our efforts to increase the number of teachers getting their bachelor's degree, when you go across the state, it's probably better than 50% now of those administrators have vocational backgrounds.
What would you like to tell faculty that why should they teach graduate education?
I would encourage faculty to get out in the community that where they have the subject matter. If they're teaching in engineering, go out into industry and see what's going on in industry. But I would encourage all faculty to not be afraid to visit a high school and see the students who are being prepared to come and take their courses later on. And so my point is, it works very well for them. I think it would work very well for my colleagues, and hopefully it would generate some interest in somebody who would want to take my place.
Excellent. Well, I don't think you'll be able to be replaced, but somebody can fill in a little bit for your work. And congratulations. I think clearly this is a well-deserved honor.
Thank you.
Thank you.